With Space Jam: A New Legacy only weeks away, we're getting brand new TV spots and footage left, right and centre. There hasn't been a great deal to cover recently, with most footage being recycled from, or just continuations of, stuff seen in trailers or previous spots. However, Warners have just released perhaps our most exciting spot yet, filled with some great movie references and Easter eggs. So let's break it all down. Before we get into this, don't forget to hit that like button down below. It does wonders in getting my content out there, and if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to keep up to date with all my content. One of the most exciting things we've learned about New Legacy so far is not only that the movie will take place on the courts, but we'll see LeBron and the Toons traveling through numerous movie-themed worlds within the Warner Brothers serververse. While we'd hoped to get a glimpse of some of these in the previous trailers, nothing really got offered up to us. However, a new 30-second spot from Warners has delivered us a whole bunch of goodies. The spot starts off with the usual chunk of footage of LeBron being sucked into the serververse before plummeting through the vast expanse towards Toon World. We get the standard few shots of the basketball court and the Toons coming out to play, and of course the obligatory shot of the Iron Giant slamming through the stadium. We do get a great new shot of LeBron and the team standing on the court looking out over Toon World though, which looks really fantastic from this angle. Of course, there are dozens and dozens of references here to some classic Looney Tunes cartoons, which I broke down in my last trailer video. If you want to check that one out, it's linked above or at the end of this one. We also get a great new shot of the Toons in their traditionally animated designs, aboard Marvin's ship. Porky is taking a photo of them all using an old-timey plate camera when Wile E. Coyote, in a classically inspired Toon gag, drops a stick of dynamite onto the Flash and blows them all up. There's additionally a new shot of Lil Ray Howery as one of the commentators at the basketball game. We haven't seen too much of him in these trailers just yet, but we've known that he was cast in the movie for quite a while now. Now we jump into the meat and potatoes of it all, as the trailer ushers us into the Tooniverse. First up, we get a fantastic Mad Max inspired sequence, which sees Wile E. Coyote and the Roadrunner caught up in the War Boys trailblazing chase sequence from Fury Road. While the Max films are set in the deserts of the Australian outback, this setting certainly fits Wile E. and Roadrunner, who are often seen chasing each other through the deserts of the American Southwest. Throw in the chase element from Mad Max and this works perfectly. I'd be keen to know if the background plates here are ripped directly from Fury Road or if this is newly doctored footage. It does look pretty authentic, and some of this other stuff that we're about to take a look at I think will prove that these are shots ripped directly from the film. Next up, we have a small Matrix parody featuring Granny in the role of Trinity, who was of course played by Carrie-Anne Moss. Granny seems to be taking on a new attitude in this movie, and I'm absolutely loving it. While some of this may seem a little off character for her, one of the recent Looney Tunes series did establish her as having previously been a spy during World War II, so it'll be interesting to see if they play around with this element in Space Jam. Definitely interesting to note here is that this scene that Granny has been dropped into is ripped directly from the first Matrix film, where we're first introduced to Trinity. Looks like we might be getting some scenes where our Toons are quite literally placed into some of our favourite movie scenes. Really keen to see how this is going to work in a narrative form, or if this is just going to be like a few brief flashes here and there. But whatever the case, I am very excited for it. While we had known about the Matrix and Mad Max worlds for quite some time, perhaps the most interesting thing here is an Austin Powers reference, which sees Alma Fudd placed into the role of Dr. Evil's mini clone, Mini-Me. This is never something I would have thought of, but it works so damn well, particularly with Alma's little chrome dome. Again, this is taken directly from the Austin Powers sequel, The Spy Who Shagged Me, in a scene where we meet Mini-Me for the very first time. I really am loving it. loving this so far. And finally, we get our first look inside the DC world, which is something that I've been dying to see. However, this time, instead of dropping some tunes into a previously existing film, we've got a newly animated sequence which sees Bugs and LeBron dressed as Batman and Robin, racing through the streets in this hilarious Batmobile, or should I say, Bunnymobile. Really, really exciting to finally get a little bit of footage of this, as a set of Funko Pop vinyls were recently released with these characters in costume. That's obviously given Warners a little more confidence to release some of this footage. Again, what is interesting to note here is LeBron pondering, "I can't wait to see what I turn into here." Inferring, I guess as we have established, that each time the characters are dropped into a new world, they'll take on a new form relative to that world. At that, I'm so keen to see what other character variants we are going to get throughout this absolutely insane looking movie. The trailer rounds out with a couple of other interesting shots. We see some kind of destruction, or perhaps formation, of the Tune world. I can't really even speculate about what is going on here because, honestly, I have no idea. And then there is this hilarious footage of LeBron and the Tunes jiving at some crazy hip-hop disco. We have seen footage of this sequence in other spots previously, and I'm so keen to see what on earth is going on here. This movie is going to be so wacky, and I am here for it. The trailer rounds out with a new shot of Bugs behind the wheel of Marvin's ship as he calls someone a nerd in classic Bugs style, and then we get this brief gag of Marvin's ship drawbridge being dropped onto Marvin's head. Though I believe this clip may have been used in previous spots, the shot marks our first look at Marvin's 3D design in New Legacy, despite that certification logo quite literally covering his entire body. Oh hey look, it's the Jetsons! And the Flintstones! Please, Space Jam, please give us the crossover we deserve! And with that, that's pretty much all we have to dissect from this one. It's crazy how, with each passing trailer and spot, we get a much, much wider idea of what to expect from this film, and all the crazy directions it's going to take us. At this point, I'm feeling maybe they are showing us a little bit too much, so I am hesitant to watch any more of these spots going forwards. But that said, once again, I am so excited to see this in only a couple of weeks' time. I've got my tickets ready, and I'll have plenty more coverage over the next month. So get excited for plenty more Space Jam and Looney Tunes content as we go into July. If you'd like to keep up to date with all the biggest cartoon news, don't forget to like and subscribe to see more regular installments like this. And if you're keen on diving deep into the history of all your favorite animated characters, don't forget to check out my continuing Cartoon Evolution series linked at the end of the video. And at that, I'm throwing it over to you. I want to know, what are your thoughts on all this new Space Jam footage? Are you excited for all the weird and wonderful moments this movie is set to offer us? And do you think maybe Warner Brothers is just giving away a little bit too much at this point? I would be happy not seeing anything else before I saw the film. Of course, fire away with all this down in the comments below and let me know your thoughts. Hey everyone, if you haven't yet, smash that big old subscribe button up on your screen to keep up to date with all my content and hit that like button down below. Also, don't forget to check me out on social media and please consider supporting me over on Patreon for as little as a dollar a month for exclusive videos, early access content, and to get your name up on the screen. Thanks again for watching.